average way of carving a turkey is people just get it out of the oven and they start hacking at it. It's about breaking it down into its primals, and then you carve it ready for plating up. So you get a nice sharp knife, and it is Christmas, so treat yourself. Nice sharp knife, and we just get it and we cut the skin of the thigh there. And then you just peel the leg back and you cut the leg off. I'm doing this pretty quickly because obviously I know the anatomy of the bird, but you could take your time. You don't have to worry about the turkey going cold. We can get it back up to temperature easily. With the knife again, we just cut the tip of the wing, and that's kind of exposed the breast. So you could actually start to carve that now, but we're going to go a step further and we're going to take the whole of the breast lobe off. So with the sharp knife, you just concentrate on running the blade of the knife down the keel bone of the turkey and keeping the knife as close to the bone as possible. You can put your carving fork deep into the breast and then just leverage the meat back so you can see it following the line of the bone, and just take the whole of the breast meat off. There we are. See, now that's real turkey meat. Now we can put that to the tin. Get the knife and we're going to cut the rest of that wing off, because you don't want to leave anything on the carcass. And then we take the shoulder off. So with the knife, we just cut down through the skin. And the bird's cool enough so you can actually handle it. So you can actually get there and you can just peel the leg back and break it off. In the tin. Take the wing tip off to expose the whole of the breast. All we've done is concentrate on breaking the bird down into its primals. We've taken the leg off, we've taken the wing off, and we've taken the whole of the breast off. There's been a big move recently to people buying crowns and joints and breast meats and things like that. That's fine if you really, really don't want a whole turkey or if there's so few of you. But all we do as turkey farmers is take the whole price of the legs and the wings and everything we cut off it, we put it onto the front, the crown or the breast. So you pretty much pay for the whole turkey anyway, so you may as well have it. And cooking the bird, cooking the whole turkey with all that meat on the bone, you get a much better eating experience and it's far better value. So you can see, if we hold that up, just how much meat we've got off the carcass. You'll get, on average, 30% more servings out of your bird by doing it this way. Don't throw that away, it makes fantastic soup. So, we get one of the breasts out into your carving plate, and then peel the skin off for those that love it. And then you've got the breast in the plate there. Now, you see, you can start to carve lovely slices, even slices of turkey meat. And by cutting the meat through the grain this way, you get a much better bite on the meat and the texture's a lot better. So you hold the leg and then you can just carve again slices of beautiful turkey onto your plate. And a sharp knife is just as important as a meat thermometer. It makes the job so much easier. The main reason for carving it like this is you get so much more out of the bird. So we've carved the meat. It's in the bottom of the carving plate. If you're worried the meat's a bit tepid, not quite warm enough, it's very easy to bring it back up to temperature. We've got the stock piping hot, and then we're just pouring that over the meat, and that takes up the full flavour of the turkey.